Welcome to today's tutorial. Today in the first task we will be learning about debuggers. So what is a debugger? A debugger allows you to inspect a program execution and manipulate your programs. The purpose of it is basically to study what's going on in your program, to find bugs and make sure that the program runs as intended. It's superior to using printf for outputting individual variables, by allowing you to really follow the individual execution steps as they are executed by the computer system. So the debugger basically will be in charge, takes control of manipulating this program. So it's basically a program that observes and manipulates yet another program, which is the one that you have built. Okay, how to use it? Well, typically you run your program up to a certain point that is close to the error that you may encounter, and then you inspect as a developer the data and the behavior that's going on in the program, and you compare it to your expectation of this kind of behavior. And we saw, maybe you've seen the error which is called segmentation fault or any other critical error, and that are again cases in which you want to use a debugger. Yeah, in this case, when you have such a critical error which crashes your program, the debugger will automatically stop at a critical error, allowing you to inspect the situation. Okay, so we will use today first GDB, which is a command line debugger, the GNU debugger, and it's also integrated in many IDEs, stands for Integrated Developer Environments, such as Atom. And I'll show you at the end how to use Atom. The purpose why we use the command line debugger is because you have to familiarize yourself with the concepts. Yeah, and the concepts are most clear when you write individual commands instead of having a bloated GUI that kind of hides the fundamental features. Good. Before you run your program, you must compile it with the dash G flag when you use GCC, or dash G3 flag that adds most debugging information, such as debugging symbols. So the debugger requires this information to make sure that it can give you the most accurate information. Good, to get started, what we'll do, we will have a look at a program, and what we'll do later in this tutorial, you have the choice as part of the steps to either take the simple program called line count, which is well discussed here as part of the sheet, or use the more complicated program called ArrayStats. And I will use the ArrayStats program instead. Okay, so how to get it? Well, I clone our CS1PR solutions repository. So in this repository, it was in week 5, we had a program called ArrayStats.